I don't know what I'm in for with this, because I don't know this group as far as I know. Commander Cody and the Lost Planet Airmen. You know what keeps popping into my head when, I mean, this is a request. First, let's see who requested this one. This is a request by Big John 527. So first, shout out to you. And you know the Honeymooners? I know Norton got on this kick with, Buzz Lightyear? Was that his name? That was before my time, but that's what popped into my head. When I see, and the Lost Planet Airmen, that's what I think I'm in for. Something like that. So, I absolutely know zero, as far as I know, about these guys. And in fact, I hope they're country. If not, you won't be seeing it.
My pappy said, son, you're going to drive me to drinking if you don't stop driving that Hot Rod Lincoln.
Hot Rod Lincoln is the name of it.
Have you heard the story of the hot rod race with the Fords and Lincolns was setting the pace? That story is true, I'm here to say, I was driving that Model A. It's got a Lincoln motor and it's really souped up. That Model A body makes it look like a pup's got 8 cylinders and uses them all. Got overdrive, just won't stall. With a 4-barrel carb and a dual exhaust, with 4 living gears you can really get lost. Got safety tubes, but I ain't scared. The brakes are good, tires fair. Pulled out of San Pedro late one night, the moon and the stars was shining bright. We was driving up Grapevine Hill, passing cars like they was standing still. All of a sudden, in a wink of an eye, a Cadillac sedan passed us by. Said, boys, it's a mark for me. By then, the taillight was all you could see. Now the fellas ribbed me for being behind, so I thought I'd make the Lincoln unwind. Took my foot off the gas, and man alive, I shoved it on down into overdrive. Wound it up to 110, my speedometer said that I hit top end. My foot was glued like lead to the floor, that's all there is, and there ain't no more.
Is that 110, is that top end for that vehicle? I mean, maybe it was. I mean, didn't he say that 4 gears? So, but I mean, that doesn't mean it's limited, but all right, here we go. This ain't gonna go right.
Now the boys all thought lost my sense, and telephone poles looked like a picket fence. They said, slow down, I see spots. The lines on the road just look like dots.
Yeah.
Took a corner, sideswiped the truck, crossed my fingers just for luck. My fenders was clicking the guardrail post. The guy beside me was white as a ghost. Smoke was coming from out of the back when I started to gain on that Cadillac. Knew I could catch him, I thought I could pass. Don't you know by then we'd be low on gas. We had flames coming from out of the side. Feel the tension, man, what a ride. I said, look out, boys, I got a license to fly. And that caddy pulled over and let us by. Now all of a sudden she started knocking him down in the dip. She started to rock, and I looked in the mirror. Red light was blinking, the cops was after my Hot Rod Lincoln.
Free radar.
They arrested me and they put me in jail, and they called my pappy to throw my bail. And he said, son, you're gonna drive me to drinking if you don't stop driving that Hot Rod Lincoln.
Well, he wrecked it. Oh, there was so much more they could have done with this song. That was fun. It just brings back memories. Every guy, guys definitely drive way crazier than girls do. Forget political correctness. There's a reason our insurance is like double or triple what girls is. Man, did I drive crazy back in the day. And almost all my friends, I had one friend who didn't, and we used to make fun of him. But he became an accountant. Go figure. Unbelievable the way we used to drive. Like, I can relate to putting it on that middle line and just seeing those dots coming back like that because you're going so fast. The line's coming up like dots, but it sounded like, I mean, he slid. I mean, the truck took off part of his fender. Then he's riding the, the guardrail, and then flames are coming out. So, I mean, I think his father got his wish when he said, bro, you don't stop driving that thing, that Hot Rod Lincoln, you're going to drive me to drinking. It sounds like, well, he already took care of that because he crashed it on some level, at least, and then it was fire coming out of it, but then the other vehicle that he was going to try racing let him go by. after I tricked somebody in it, not this bad, but this is, I don't know, 8-10 years ago. And I drive Beamers, right? That's my vehicle of choice. And I had, I don't know, it was probably like my third Beamer. I had already been driving one for 8 or 10 years or something. And then this red one comes up next to me, and there are these young folks, guy and a girl, and it's a brand new Beamer. And they're smiling and happy, and they see I'm driving a Beamer. We're in the highway, three-lane highway up here. And they're like, woo, you know, like we're part of the club. There's not a Beamer club. It's not like Jeeps where, you know, you do this, or motorcycles. And they're looking over, and they're all happy and stuff. So I'm just smiling, giving them a thumbs up, congratulations type thing, you know. And both our windows are up, so we can't communicate other than this. So I kind of gunned it up to about, I don't know, 85, right? And I knew he was just going to try blowing right by me. And I set him up because I knew it was a speed trap up ahead. And that's where, like, the cops hang out on that section of road. And they may or maybe not were there. But this guy went blowing by me at 100. And I just backed off and I made my turn. And I was like, oh, shoot. I don't know if I set that kid up. Maybe it wasn't my bravest, you know, best moment. But I can relate to the dude blowing past this guy. And then he winds up, you know, in trouble. Anyway, oh, Jesus, I'm going to rate this thing. Big John 527, thank you for introducing me to Commander Cody and his Lost Planet Airmen. I can't even imagine what other songs he's got. But on creativity, the fun factor alone is bringing, the number that popped into my head was an 8.5. It was fun. They could have done a lot more with this story. But depending on when it came out, it might have actually been risque, you know, for what he was doing. But either way, no matter how, it's still a fun song, and we got it covered here. So that's it, guys. All right. I'll see you on another video. Thanks for playing along. Leave your comments. Have a great day. Keep rocking the country.